Welcome to Hockey Whiz Talks podcast. Today, I'll be breaking down and predicting the first round of the NHL playoffs.
The first matchup in the Eastern Conference is between the Tampa Bay Lightning and the Columbus Blue Jackets. Key players for Tampa Bay: Nikita Kucherov, Steven Stamkos, Braden Point, JT Miller, Andre Palat, Tyler Johnson, Victor Hedman, Ryan McDonough, and Eric Cernak. Key players for Columbus: Artemi Panarin, Matt Duchene, Cam Atkinson, Ryan Dzingel, Pierre-Luc Dubois, Josh Anderson, Nick Foligno, Seth Jones, Zach Werenski, and David Savard. The goalie matchup is Andrei Vasilevskiy against Sergei Bobrovsky. The Tampa Bay Lightning were by far the best team in the NHL in the regular season. However, as we all know in the playoffs, that all goes out the window. The Columbus Blue Jackets went all in this season to win the Stanley Cup. If they don't win the Stanley Cup, they could lose all three of their top players in free agency. Unfortunately for the Blue Jackets, they have a really tough first round matchup against the Tampa Bay Lightning. Tampa Bay Lightning seem focused on winning the Stanley Cup this year, similar to how the Washington Capitals were last year. This is the first ever playoff matchup between Tampa Bay and Columbus. This season, the Lightning have won all their games against Columbus. Given how this season went between the two teams, it seems like the Lightning have a severe advantage. My prediction is that the Tampa Bay Lightning win 4-1. The next matchup in the Eastern Conference is between the Washington Capitals and the Carolina Hurricanes. Key players for the Washington Capitals: Alex Ovechkin, Evgeny Kuznetsov, Nicholas Backstrom, TJ Oshie, Tom Wilson, Jacob Virana, Lars Eller, John Carlson, Dmitry Orlov, Matt Niskanen. Key players for the Carolina Hurricanes: Sebastian Aho, Toivo Teravainen, Nino Niederreiter, Jordan Staal, Justin Williams, Andrei Svechnikov, Dougie Hamilton, Justin Falk, Jacob Slavin. The goalie matchup is Braden Holtby versus Peter Mrazek. The Washington Capitals are defending Stanley Cup champions, but their road back to the Stanley Cup won't be easy. Don't underestimate the Carolina Hurricanes. They are a young, hungry team that have nothing to lose. The Hurricanes are going to be massive underdogs heading into the series, which is actually a real advantage for them. On the flip side of things, the Washington Capitals have all the pressure on them to win the series easily. So if they struggle to beat Carolina, the narrative will be that the Washington Capitals won't get past the second round. So far this season, the Washington Capitals have won all their matchups against the Carolina Hurricanes. Even though the Capitals seem like the better team on paper, anything is possible come playoff time. My prediction is that the Washington Capitals win 4-1. The next matchup in the Eastern Conference is between the Boston Bruins and the Toronto Maple Leafs. Key players for the Boston Bruins: Brad Marchand, David Pastrnak, Patrice Bergeron, David Krejci, Jake DeBrusk, David Backes, Charlie Coyle, Charlie McAvoy, Zdeno Chara, Torrey Krug. Key players for the Toronto Maple Leafs: John Tavares, Austin Matthews, Mitch Marner, William Nylander, Nazem Kadri, Kasperi Kapanen, Andreas Johnsson, Morgan Riley, Jake Muzzin, Jake Gardner. The goalie matchup is Tukaras against Frederik Andersen. In the 2010s, the Boston Bruins owned the Toronto Maple Leafs in the playoffs. The main reason for that is because of the way these two teams play. The Leafs like to play a fast, up-tempo game and have puck control entering the offensive zone. While the Bruins are built around their defense, most of their scoring chances actually come from great defensive plays. A huge concern heading into the playoffs for the Maple Leafs is that they are one of the worst defensive teams in the second half. On the other hand, the Boston Bruins are one of the hottest teams in the league in the second half. The last two meetings between the two teams resulted in a dramatic Game 7 victory by the Bruins. So far this season, the Bruins are 3-1 against the Leafs. Based off the previous track record against the Maple Leafs, the Bruins seem to have an edge on them. My prediction is that the Boston Bruins win the series 4-3. The last matchup in the Eastern Conference is between the New York Islanders and the Pittsburgh Penguins. Key players for the New York Islanders: Matt Barzal, Anders Lee, Brock Nelson, Josh Bailey, Jordan Eberle, Kasis Zekas, Kyle Clutterbuck, Nick Leddy, Johnny Boychuk, Ryan Pulock. Key players for the Pittsburgh Penguins: Sidney Crosby, Evgeny Malkin, Phil Kessel, Jake Guentzel, Patrick Hornquist, Nick Bjugstad, Jared McCann, Chris Letang, Brian Dumoulin, Justin Schultz. The goalie matchup is Thomas Greiss against Matt Murray. The days of the Pittsburgh Penguins being favorites to win the Stanley Cup are long gone, but they are still a dangerous threat in the playoffs as long as they have Crosby, Malkin, Letang, and Kessel. Despite being a higher seed, the New York Islanders are underdogs in this series due to the fact their young core doesn't have much playoff experience. However, the Islanders do have Barry Trotz, the same coach that helped guide the Washington Capitals past the Pittsburgh Penguins last year. In their last postseason matchup in 2013, the Pittsburgh Penguins won the series 4-2. So far this season, both teams have split the season series. However, because of how different the playoffs are, I would not count out the possibility of a sweep by the Penguins. My prediction is that the Pittsburgh Penguins win 4-1. And now, word from our sponsor. Welcome back to Hockey Whiz Talks podcast. Now I'll be previewing the Western Conference matchups. The first matchup in the Western Conference is between the Calgary Flames and the Colorado Avalanche. Key players for the Calgary Flames: Johnny Gaudreau, Sean Monahan, Matthew Tkachuk, Elias Lindholm, Mikael Backlund, Michael Frolik, James Neal, Mark Giordano, TJ Brody, Noah Hanifin. Key players for the Colorado Avalanche: Nathan MacKinnon, Mikko Rantanen, and Gabriel Landeskog. Alex Kerfoot, JT Comfer, Tyson Jost, Derek Brassard, Tyson Barry, Eric Johnson, Samuel Girard. The goalie matchup is Mike Smith against Philip Grubauer. The Calgary Flames had the best record in the Western Conference in the regular season, but don't underestimate the Colorado Avalanche, who pushed the Nashville Predators to 6 games last season. The Colorado Avalanche are a young, hungry team that have nothing to lose, while the Calgary Flames have all the pressure on them. The Calgary Flames have so many weapons in their lineup, you never know who the best player will be from game to game. Johnny Gaudreau, Elias Lindholm, and Mark Giordano have elevated their level of play. If the Flames want to win the series, these players will need to continue playing at that level. It's hard to believe this, but this is the first time the Flames and Avalanche will meet in the playoffs. So far this season, the Flames are 3-0 against the Avalanche. The Calgary Flames should win this matchup because they are the better team on paper. My prediction is that the Calgary Flames win 4-2. The next matchup in the Western Conference is between the Winnipeg Jets and the Dallas Stars. Key players for the Winnipeg Jets: Blake Wheeler, Mark Scheifele, Patrick Laine, Kyle Connor, Nikolaj Ehlers, Kevin Hayes, Dustin Byfuglien, Jacob Trouba, Tyler Myers. Key players for the Dallas Stars: Tyler Seguin, Jamie Benn, Alex Radulov, Rupe Hintz, Radek Foxma, Jason Spezza, John Klingberg, Issa Lindell, Miro Heiskanen. The goalie matchup is Connor Hellebuck against Ben Bishop. This should be an easy victory for the Winnipeg Jets, but the Stars could easily pull off an upset for these two reasons. 1. Josh Morrissey could miss some games in the first round. And 2. Ben Bishop is a big game goalie who is capable of stealing some games. The Winnipeg Jets have a scary looking top 6 right now, but their defense is suspect without Josh Morrissey. Without Morrissey, the Jets will struggle a bit against big power forwards like Jamie Benn and Alex Radulov. The Dallas Stars don't have as much depth as the Jets, but they have some real superstar talent on the roster. They will need Tyler Seguin and Jamie Benn to play like superstars if they want to win the series. This will be the first time the Winnipeg Jets and Dallas Stars will face in the playoffs. So far this season, the Winnipeg Jets are 3-1 against the Dallas Stars. The Winnipeg Jets are just a better all-around team than the Dallas Stars and should come out on top. My prediction is that the Winnipeg Jets win the series 4-2. The next matchup in the Western Conference is between the Nashville Predators and the St. Louis Blues. Key players for the Nashville Predators: Philip Forsberg, Ryan Johansson, Victor Arvidsson, Mikael Granlund, Kyle Turris, Wayne Simmonds, Craig Smith, Roman Josi, Ryan Ellis, Matthias Ekholm, PK Subban. Key players for the St. Louis Blues: Vladimir Tarasenko, Ryan O'Reilly, Braden Schenn, Jaden Schwartz, Tyler Bozak, Alex Steen, David Perron, Alex Pietrangelo, Vince Dunn, Colton Parenko. The goalie matchup is Pekka Rinne against Jordan Binnington. This is one of the better first-round matchups. The Nashville Predators are one of the deepest teams in the NHL. They have a terrific defense and a great group of forwards as well. While the St. Louis Blues are a more improved team, with the additions of Ryan O'Reilly, Tyler Bozak, Patrick Maroon, and David Perron, they also have some young players that can chip in, like Robert Thomas, Ivan Barbashev, and Vince Dunn. The biggest issue for the Blues in the past years was goaltending. They might have found their solution in Jordan Binnington. The Nashville Predators are the more dominant team on paper, but in the playoffs, anything can happen. Historically, the Nashville Predators have a 4-2 record against the St. Louis Blues. So far this season, the Blues have a 4-1 edge in the season series. The St. Louis Blues always seem to come up short. It's hard to think that this season will be any different. My prediction is that the Nashville Predators win the series 4-2. The final matchup in the Western Conference is between the Vegas Golden Knights and the San Jose Sharks. Key players for the San Jose Sharks: Joe Pavelski, Logan Couture, Thomas Hertl, Timo Meier, Evander Kane, Joe Thornton, Gustav Nyquist, Brent Burns, Erik Karlsson, Mark-Edward Vlasic. This is one of the matchups I am personally looking forward to. There are so many new faces in the lineup from the last playoff matchup between the two teams. The Vegas Golden Knights added Mark Stone, Paul Stastny, and Max Pacioretty, while the San Jose Sharks added Erik Karlsson and Gustav Nyquist. The Vegas Golden Knights have been one of the hottest teams in the NHL since the trade deadline, while the San Jose Sharks have struggled a bit down the stretch. On paper, this is a pretty even matchup, so it will be interesting to see who wins this series. The Vegas Golden Knights beat the San Jose Sharks 4-2. So far this season, the Golden Knights have a 2-1 edge in the series. The Vegas Golden Knights seem to be built for the playoffs. For that reason, they have a slight edge over the Sharks. My prediction is that the Vegas Golden Knights win the series 4-2. In my next podcast, I'll be updating you on the first round of the NHL playoffs.